Now let's go through a quick JavaScript tutorial. So first thing I want us to introduce or to learn is the constants that we're going to use in JavaScript. So you will see that there are numbers, there are strings, there are booleans, and there is something known as undefined. Undefined is this special parameter. You can think of it as null, although it's not null. So if I copy paste this, if I run it, nothing happens, because unlike Racket, it only shows something if you print it. So you need to do console.log. Then if you console log, then it will print out the number. As you can see here, 100. So .log, console.log. As you can see, you can write strings with two quotes or a double quote or double or single quote. Both work. Booleans have the same syntax as in Java. So low caps, true. And undefined is all low caps. So if you run this, you can see all the values showing up. So I'm using Node to run, and Node actually prints out colors. So you can see that this is numbers show up in gold, strings appear normally, so if I in black, right? But if I convert that into a number, a string, now it shows up in black. But if it's a number or true or false, it prints out in golden, this golden color. That's just a functionality of Node. Okay. Or Node log, I guess. Console log for Node. So these are your primitive types. And then we have expressions, right? And expressions in JavaScript, they may be either objects or functions. And we'll also learn that functions are objects, so essentially expressions are objects. So what are objects in JavaScript? Well, as we will learn, objects are very easy to create in JavaScript. So I can comment all this out. And when you write this, this is an object. So you can think of it this is the syntax for a dictionary, let's say, like you have in Java or in Python. So a map or a dictionary or what else it's called. I think that's it. So you can define a variable with var x equals. And now if I do print, x, not print, console. It will print out my object, which in this case is an empty one. So it's an empty map, right? And I can define things with the usual way. So curly braces and then strings as keys and expressions as values. So I could have first, and then I can call John, and then separated with commas. Last name would be Smith. Okay, so if I print this in Node, it actually prints out colors in green. Could also call Jane Doe, just so it's different name. You see it showing up. Okay, so we can define keys and values, and the values don't need to be strings, so it could be the number 10. That also works. It could also be a number 10 in the key, I believe. I think that's a problem. And when you do, it is converted to a string, which is always wonderful. So if I do, what happens if I do x of 10? Somehow it works. Oh, wow. If I do 10. Interesting. Okay. So it converts, if you put a number in the key, it converts it to a string. And then when you use it again, it's converted again. So it's behind the scenes, anything you store should be a string. So for now, we're going to consider, because we're going to keep it simple, keys are strings. Values are expressions. So if they're expressions, they could be this minus 90. Then it should work, right? This is the just to make it a bit clearer. Okay. So why is 10? Ah, okay. So it's printing 90 because I did this. Okay. Yeah, because 100 minus 10 is 90, and that's in the position 10. Okay. So now I'm going to do first. I'm going to do Jane. Okay. Jane Doe. If in this case I looked up 10, 10 is not defined in the object X, right? So when a key is not defined, then it returns undefined. So that's why you need undefined. Okay, but if I do first, it prints out Jane. Okay, if I do last, it should print out Doe. Okay. And if I write last, we could put capital L. It shows undefined because it is, of course, case sensitive. Okay, so we've learned how to look up values, how to define values, right, where we assign them. You can assign a value. Oops, let me assign. So you can do last equals Doe Lewis. Okay, so Jane Lewis. So you can assign something to a dictionary, which is an object again. So you can assign a field, and you, so in this case, I'm using last, and I'm redefining it to be Lewis. And if I print X, you see that first name is still Jane, last name is Lewis, because this is mutable, so the object itself is being mutated. Okay. I can even delete something, so I could... also, I can add things that weren't defined previously. So in this case, I'm redefining something. But I can also write middle to be M. Okay. And now when I print it, it shows middle here. So it doesn't have to be initially defined. You can add things in the middle as, you know, you can. It's just a regular dictionary. So you can add things as you want. And you can even delete them. So if I do delete X... middle. Now the name won't appear again if I print it again. So as you can see, after deletion, the name disappears. Okay, so what we saw in recap, we have a way to explicitly define an object. The keys have to be strings. You can store whatever you want as a value. You can assign things to update or to define whenever there, you know, this key isn't there, so now it is with this assignment. You can delete things from the dictionary with delete, and you can print out all the contents just by doing print X. So far, so good. We've learned all this. We've learned object declaration, field lookup, field update, and field deletion. Another thing we can do is using the dot notation. So I can rewrite everything I wrote. Okay, so it would be the same thing exactly, but using the dot notation. Actually, let me just do this little bit right here. Okay, so the code above is exactly the same as the code below, but now I'm going to use the dot notation. So in JavaScript, you can write it this way as well. It's actually more standard, I would say, more idiomatic. So instead of writing a string with quotes and all that, you can just do x dot last. This will look up this code. Middle, and that is, I guess, one of the ideas why you want to enforce this to be a string, right? Because otherwise you wouldn't even be able to type it. And you can update like this, you can delete it like that. So if I print out, I should see exactly the same thing happening. Okay. We can use the dot notation, or we can use the brackets notation. They're exactly the same thing. I can also define x as x.first equals Jane. So in the second example, what I did was I created a new object x, and I created from scratch just by defining fields. Like, so here we are defining a field, and here as well, using the dot notation. Okay, so we're good. We know how to use the dot notation now. We've learned that strings, numbers are converted to strings, booleans as well. Booleans are left as is, wonderful. You can store undefined as a key. You can store null as well. Null exists as well, forgot to tell you. Although we're not gonna console.lol log null. Null is also something that exists in this language. So they have the concept of null and the concept of undefined. They're sometimes the same thing, sometimes they aren't. So we're not gonna be bothered with null. And for the rest of this course, we just care about keys that are strings. We're not gonna care about undefined and null or weird things, booleans being stored in objects. So this slide is just showing you the quirks of the language. Okay, so next, let's cover functions in JavaScript. Okay, so you can define a lambda in JavaScript with a parenthesis arrow notation. So this is just my weird font where it kind of shows, but it's equal greater than sign. It's not a... Okay, so if I want to write this code, this code works. Let's see what it does. All right, it just doesn't assert. Ah, you have console assert, huh? This is nice. So basically your test case is you can write them with console.assert. If this condition fails, then the whole thing fails. If you write false, it says assertion failed. If you do one is greater than zero, let's see what it shows. It just says assertion failed. Pretty lame. Doesn't tell you what condition is being. Okay, and here basically what I did was I created a lambda that when given y returns x minus y, and I created a lambda that when given x returns this lambda. And then I'm passing 1 to x and 2 to y. So 1 minus 2 is why you're returning minus 1. So by now I'm hoping you are experts in lambdas and all that, so this code is pretty trivial to you. This arrow notation, again, this is equal greater than. It's just that my font renders it as a single arrow. This arrow notation doesn't work in all versions of JavaScript, but if you use Node, it should work. What version do I have in Node? Minus, minus version? 12, 13, 1. Perfect. Okay, so the code on the left equals the code on the right. No surprises here. You can also call, so these are lambdas, as you know, as are also known as unnamed functions. You can also have named functions by writing function and then the name. You can also use function, which is even more confusing, but so let's go for that. You can write the addition in this code. Okay, let me log all the consoles. Okay, so now hopefully there's no... Beautiful. So now I defined a function, I called it a name, and I return. In this case, I'm adding two numbers together, and you call it as you would usually do it, you know, like C-style programming languages. You write function name, open parentheses, and then comma separated values. Okay, and equal is comparison, as you would expect. Already used it here first. So if I add 1 and 2 together, you get 3. Nothing too surprising. Console assert is also new. I just showed you what it does. So hopefully no surprise. You can write arrow. This is known as the arrow notation for lambdas, and you can write them named functions. As we'll see, named functions are a bit more powerful than unnamed functions. Okay, so now let's write this, and I just want to show you some syntactic sugar and some subtleties of JavaScript. What is this? Ah, beautiful. So, why am I showing you all this? I want to show you all this because it's good to understand, to kind of distill, if, when you're learning a programming language, you want to distill what are the core features, and then what is syntactic sugar. So for instance, you can think of version 1 as the lowest form, right? So you have P1, and I'm defining an object, adding two fields to it, X, Y. And then I'm checking if what I've set is being read correctly. So in this case, X assigned to 13, Y assigned to 7, and then everything is being looked up correctly. So you can think of creating an object with this notation as just syntactic sugar for this. Why is that important? Because then it means you only need to define the creation of the empty object, and then define how you add another field to it. And then you can think of this as just a special case of this, right? So if you think of it from the implementer's perspective, it's much easier to just think about something where you, oh, how do I create an empty object? Good, can do that. How do I add a field to an object? I can do that. And if you just implement those functionalities, you can think of, you know, defining an object where you define all fields as just a special case that can be handled just as syntactic sugar. And we can see that you can even do that just by a single pass through the source code. And, you know, whenever you see this, you expand it into that and everything would work. Another version is the dot notation, right? So you can also see the dot notation as just syntactic sugar for this, where the programmer doesn't want to write the brackets and the quotes and all that. Okay. Alrighty then. So another thing I want to confirm is just how equality works, because I think equality is kind of iffy in JavaScript. Yeah, so this is just exclamation mark equals. It kind of renders it like this in my font. But basically what I want to show you is that when you use two equals, you can't compare, you're not comparing it, the contents. You're comparing the references. So I think if you want to compare, so here we're saying that P1 and P2 are different because they are different objects. That's what it's saying. It's the same idea as in Java, if you're familiar with that language. So if you want to compare its contents, I believe you need three equals. No, I don't know how to do it. Honestly, it's not important. So this is just to say, when you compare things in JavaScript, be careful, because you might want to need to compare it point-wise, so field by field. Okay. So again, equals is reference. You can think of the dot notation as just syntactic sugar, and the object, again, as a synonym for this, for open and close brackets. Okay. So next, in the next video, we're going to start learning LambdaJS. So strap yourselves in.